Heidi ho, neighbors, Beefy here, and today we're going to learn how to fly an aileron roll. In this video, we're going to cover what the heck is an aileron roll, entry parameters and energy management, execution of the aileron roll, and some common student errors. Training rules do apply to this maneuver since it's aerobatic, so before you start doing flips and stuff all willy-nilly, remember that you need at least 6,000 feet AGL, you need to be able to maintain clear of clouds throughout the execution of the maneuver, you need 3 statute miles of visibility, and you need a discernible horizon. A warning for your health and well-being, the content of this video is for the T6 Alpha only. While most of the aerodynamic principles discussed hereafter do apply to pretty much everything that flies, attempting to replicate this maneuver in aircraft that are not the T6 Alpha can result in some serious boo-boos. Similarly, this video will reference some block altitudes for MOAs at Vance Air Force Base specifically, because, well, that's where it was filmed. If you're visiting this channel from another training base, welcome! Reference your own local pubs and use your nugget before you bust your own MOA for no reason. If you're a student pilot at Vance and you don't know what an aileron roll is, I fear for your future. But at the risk of sounding like I'm talking down to you, an aileron roll is a basic aerobatic maneuver whereby you use the ailerons, those primary flight control surfaces on your wings, and roll 360 degrees around the longitudinal axis of the aircraft. It gets a fuzz more complicated than that in execution, but not really all that much. The point of an aileron roll is to introduce you to the basic principles of energy management for aerobatic maneuvers in the MOA. You probably got a taste of some basic energy management flying other maneuvers prior to aerobatics, but baby aero is where energy management becomes increasingly critical if you're going to maintain your MOA boundaries. So with that in mind, where the heck in the MOA are we? It looks like we're at about 8,900 feet, zipping along at just a little more than 180 knots. This is going to be fine for this maneuver, but if this is the first in a set of MOA maneuvers, it might be smarter to be closer to the 248 recommended neutral energy state of 9,500 feet at 180 to 200 knots. As far as altitude is concerned, over the execution of an aileron roll, you can expect to gain about 1,000 feet, so as long as you have that above you, you can go ahead and execute. However, you should plan this current maneuver with the next one in mind. If you want to do a split S next, for example, 9,500 feet is a good idea, because I'll be at about 10,500 feet after my aileron roll is done. The airspeed range to execute the aileron roll is between 180 and 220 knots. The power setting range is between 80% and max. For the execution of the aileron roll, there isn't much of a difference between the extremes of torque and airspeed. The higher the airspeed, the less stick deflection you're going to need for the same rate of roll. And you may gain slightly more altitude over the course of the maneuver. As you use more torque, you might see a slight increase in the amount of rudder you need to keep the nose track correct, but it doesn't have a very significant impact on your airspeed at the end of the maneuver. When you make your initial pull, bring the nose between 20 and 30 degrees nose high. Yes, I'm showing this to you on the EADI for demonstrative purposes, but don't stare at the EADI in the plane. It'll make you sick. Use your outside visual references, which we'll get to in a second. If you need to increase your airspeed, you can pitch your nose down 10 degrees, and at max power you'll gain about 50 knots for every 1,000 feet of altitude lost. If you're too fast, pitching the nose up 10 degrees at max power will decrease your airspeed about 50 knots for every 1,000 feet of altitude gain. You're going to want to remember that. So let's get on with this thing. When your torque is set between 80% and max, and you're between 180 and 220 knots, begin the maneuver by pulling the stick straight back towards your zipper to put the horizon somewhere between the top of the airspeed indicator and the bottom of the canopy vents. Depending on your sitting height, this corresponds with between 20 and 30 degrees nose high. When you reach that attitude, relax the backstick pressure, and push the stick straight left or right as far as it will go. If you're small and weak, you can use two hands. If you do squats, or you don't exercise enough, which is probably the case, stop lying to yourself, you may hit your thigh. Push harder. Maintain this side stick pressure for about 3/4 of the roll. For the last quarter of the roll, gradually decrease the side stick pressure in order to roll out to a wings level attitude. When your wings level in parallel with the horizon, you have completed the aileron roll. The reason you're back at the horizon is because of the positive camber of the wings, which provide a lift vector towards the top of the plane pretty much any time you're flying. When you're upright, this has the effect of holding you straight and level. When you're inverted, it has the effect of pulling you towards Mother Earth. You shouldn't end up nose low at any point during the aileron roll. If you did, you either didn't pull your nose high enough to start, or your roll rates are weak, and you brought shame on your squadron, your flight room, and your cow. Now try and push past the elation and euphoria of spinning in a circle and set yourself up for your next set of maneuvers. Now before we move on, let's talk about some pro-level stuff. You might recall part of aerodynamic theory called adverse yaw. Adverse yaw is a yawing moment away from the direction of turn. This occurs whenever you are in the process of rolling because you're introducing a vertical component to the relative airflow. If you go through all the lift vector math, the long story short is that while you're rolling, the outside wing has a backwards component of lift, and the inside wing has a forward component of lift. This pushes the nose towards the outside wing. As it turns out, the aileron roll is almost nothing but continuous bank, so this has the effect of making the nose track in a circle instead of around a point. So to prevent this, add a little pro-roll rudder as you start the maneuver, and then take that rudder out as you stop the maneuver. This will have the effect of uncoordinating the turn, but keeping the nose tracking where you want it. Alright, that's enough nerd stuff for now. Let's talk about some common student errors. First off, when setting up in the MOA, you have to consider not just the airspace above you, but in front of you as well. If students mess up the MOA during maneuvers like the aileron roll or the barrel roll, it's generally because they don't pay attention and blow out the sides. Second, and probably most obvious, you shouldn't maintain any backstick pressure after pulling the nose to 20 to 30 degrees nose high. If you do maintain that backstick pressure throughout the roll, you'll develop a large elliptical nose track, and you'll see the nose fall aggressively towards the horizon as you invert. This is a pretty similar situation to a barrel dive, and if this is where you find yourself, execute a nose low recovery. Lastly, like I mentioned before, too little or too much rudder will cause your nose track to be elliptical, like a micro barrel roll. Using rudder with the aileron is a finesse thing. The required amount depends entirely on your roll rate, so it's going to come with practice. Generally speaking, not using rudder makes for a good enough aileron roll, and too much makes for an uncomfortable one, so experiment in small increments. Now, we'll go back and play the video again in real time without all the pauses and narration. Pay extra attention to develop your visual references around the cowling and horizon for the initial pull-up, as well as hand movements required to relax the backstick pressure when transitioning from the pitch-up to the rolling portion of the aileron roll.